I'm not just saying that because the iPhone 14 Pro Max has larger lenses. It really is a formidable piece of mobile technology overall. This large screen flagship comes equipped with a new 48-megapixel camera, an always-on display, and a new A16 Bionic processor, all of which should allow it to once again outperform its Android counterparts. Hey guys, welcome to Dynamic Product Review. In today's video, we are going to talk about iPhone 14 Pro Max. So stay with us till the end of this video, so you don't miss out on any of this information. But before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so that you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. But during my hands-on time with the iPhone 14 Pro Max, the new Dynamic Island feature, which is Apple's replacement for the notch, was the thing that most piqued my interest. This pill-shaped cutout transforms into different displays depending on what you are doing, displaying anything from the countdown timer to the music that is playing in the background. The iPhone 14 Pro Max will be available for purchase beginning on September 16, and pre-orders for the iPhone 14 and its four new models will begin on September 9. There were rumors that the iPhone 14 Pro Max would be getting a price hike, but the starting price has been revealed to be $1,099, $1,899, despite the fact that this is an expensive price point. The base storage remains at 128GB, which, to be honest, doesn't feel very pro, but you have the option to upgrade to 256GB for an additional $1,199, or $2,099. The price to upgrade to 512GB is $1,399, or $2,419, and the price to upgrade to 1TB is $1,599, or $2,769. The notch on the display of the iPhone 14 Pro Max has been replaced with a new dynamic island, making it visually distinct from other iPhone models that have been introduced since 2017. This alert, notification, and activity cutout is shaped like a pill, and it occupies less space than its counterparts. For instance, after I started playing a song in Apple Music and then returned to the home screen, a small play window appeared with the album art and track information. When you do a prolonged press on the dynamic island, a pop-up will appear with additional information. When you start a timer, the information will be added to the dynamic island on the right side of the screen, providing you with a large amount of data in a condensed area. Even better, Apple is working with developers to take advantage of these features, which means that you will be able to see live sports scores or the current status of your Lyft ride, among other things. Aside from that, the design of the iPhone 14 Pro Max is virtually identical to the design of the previous model, with one significant difference. There is no longer a tray for SIM cards because Apple has shifted its focus to eSIMs as the primary method for carrier provisioning. There are going to be people who are upset about the removal of this feature, and I count myself among them. The camera bump at the back of the iPhone 14 Pro Max has been upgraded to accommodate larger sensors. The overall design is slightly more cumbersome and bulkier, coming in at 8.47 ounces and measuring 6.33 by 3.05 by 0.31 inches. As opposed to the iPhone 13 Pro Max, which measured 8.46 ounces and 6.33 by 3.07 by 0.3 inches. You can get the iPhone 14 Pro Max in deep purple, silver, gold, or space black. These are the color options you have. My personal favorite is the dark purple because it stands out the most. When I say that the display on the iPhone 14 Pro Max is the best I've seen on any smartphone so far, I'm not kidding around. This 6.7-inch panel's brightness is rated at 1,600 nits, making it one of the brightest displays available. The Pro Max has a rating of up to a whopping 2,000 nits when used outside. It gets better. The always-on display on the iPhone 14 Pro Max allows you to see your widgets and notifications even when the device is in a low-power state, but they are still displayed in color. This is a significant improvement over anything else that Android phones have attempted. The fact that the display can be scaled down to 1Hz should also mean that it uses very little power. You have a lot of leeway when it comes to how you shoot thanks to the new 48-megapixel camera on the iPhone 14 Pro Max. For the price of one, you get a sensor with 4 pixels instead of 1, which means it can record 4 times as much information. Because of this, you are able to crop in on images after the fact, or you can combine 4 pixels into 1, which results in photos that are significantly brighter. Another significant improvement to the camera is the inclusion of a telephoto zoom that is 2 times more powerful. You have the option of getting 2 or 3 times the original size of any given photograph. Apple demonstrated some sample photos, and I found myself particularly impressed by the low-light shots. This is because of a newly added computational photography feature called the Photonic Engine. This feature promises an improvement of up to 2 times in the low-light performance of the main camera, up to 3 times in the performance of the ultra-wide camera, up to 2 times in the performance of the telephoto camera, and up to 2 times in the performance of the true-depth camera. You can now record footage in cinematic mode at a resolution of up to 4K, and there is a new video mode called Action Mode that allows for smoother recording even when you are moving around. The example footage that was shown side-by-side was compelling. Although we still have a lot of testing to do, it appears that the iPhone 14 Pro Max could end up at the top of our list of the best camera phones. Apple asserts that the 6-core central processing unit of the iPhone 14 Pro Max, which utilizes a new A16 Bionic chip manufactured with a 4-nanometer process, is up to 40% more efficient than that of its competitors. In addition to that, there is a boosted 5-core GPU that has a memory bandwidth that is increased by a factor of 50. What exactly is the point of possessing so much power? The central processing unit, CPU, graphics processing unit, GPU, neural engine, and image signal processor are all designed to collaborate with one another to support the newly added camera hardware and carry out up to 4 trillion separate operations for each individual photograph. This A16 Bionic chip will be put to the test in our very own benchmarks that we have developed. Apple asserts that the iPhone 14 Pro Max has a battery life that lasts throughout the entire day. This translates to a rated 25 hours of playback time for videos streamed over the internet, despite the fact that this is the same as the iPhone 13 Pro Max. The positive result of our web browsing test was that the iPhone 13 Pro Max lasted for more than 12 hours, which places it on our list of phones with the best battery life. This fall, the iPhone 14 Pro Max will offer emergency SOS via satellite in the United States and Canada. This feature will be available when a cellular connection cannot be established. Because of this feature, the antennas are able to connect directly to a satellite, which makes it possible to communicate with emergency services. Crash detection is yet another new safety feature that will be available on the iPhone 14 Pro Max. The mobile device is equipped with a brand new dual-core accelerometer high dynamic range gyroscope, which enables it to detect a severe car accident and immediately contact emergency services. The disappointing news is that the iPhone 14 Pro Max continues to offer the same 20 watts charging as its predecessors, which means that you should anticipate reaching 50% in 30 minutes. The 30 watts charging that was rumored to be coming would have been a welcome addition. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.